some of my favorite lessons in the Montessori classroom to give, especially in math, are the squaring lessons. Now, we don't have golden beads to give you guys while you are off working from home, nor do we have some of the other fancy squaring materials, but we can work with what we've got. So you might remember in the classroom, we have these golden beads, right? Don't worry, I'm not gonna make you draw that because even just drawing in the little circles was very time consuming. But let's think back. Maybe you've had this lesson, maybe you haven't. If you have, this will help refresh your memory. If you haven't, it'll just give you a picture of why we're doing what we're doing. So, you know, we have the golden beads and then we'd have the colored hair ties or rubber bands. And you'd take that rubber band and you'd count over 1, 2, 3, and then you'd wrap it around the golden beads, making a line right there. And then you'd count the same number down. 1, 2, 3, and you'd wrap that hair tie or rubber band around the golden beads, the square of 10 golden beads, which we know is equal to 100. Now that's a helpful thing to remember here. 100 is the total value of all these. If we counted every single one of these beads, there would be 100 of them, imaginary beads. Right now they're just circles, but you get the idea. And then we would look here, and we look that we just created, or see that we had created 4 pieces. We transformed our square into 2 squares and a rectangle. Now, when I look at the dimensions of the pieces that we've created, I see a couple different dimensions. I see here 1 of those dimensions. I see 3, 1, 2, 3 by 3, 1, 2, 3. Well, 3 times 3, can't I call that 3 squared? I sure can. And then what do I have here? This rectangle. It's 3, how many do I have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 taken how many times? Well, 1, 2, 3. So 7 times 3. Then what do I have here? I have 1, 2, 3 taken how many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 3 times 7. Then what do I have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 times 7, which we know is 49, but we could also call that 7 squared. So we can take each of these pieces that we have and how we've labeled them. So for example, 3 squared, and we can add them together. 3 squared plus, we're going to put this in parentheses, 7 times 3 plus 3 times 7 plus 7 squared. Now, I know that 3 squared is equal to 9. And I know that 7 times 3 is 21. I know that 3 times 7 is 21. And 7 squared is 49. Now, let's add up the numbers that we have. Well, I could rewrite this vertically, but I really like to do it horizontally. So if you follow along, I'm just going to look at the units. So 9 plus 1 is 10, plus 1 is 11, plus 9 is 20. So I'm going to write the 0, carry the 2 in my head. 2 plus, then we go to the tens category. No tens here. 2 plus 2 is 4, plus another 2 is 6, plus 4 is 10. So these numbers, these pieces that we labeled, all add up to 100, which is perfect because we know there are exactly 100 golden beads here. Now what we can do, because we don't have the material in the class or at home, is we can draw squares of 10 to work from. So with my straight edge, I'm going to draw a square that is 10 units long, or 10 by 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. My square there. Looks pretty square to me. And then instead of having imaginary beads that we're working with, we just have a square that is 10 by 10. And then we can, instead of having a rubber band or a hair tie or anything, we can just count with our ruler. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four, and then I'm going to draw a line. And then I've got to draw another line four down. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I can label my pieces from there, just like we would if we had golden beads. But instead of golden beads, we have blue and white graph paper. We can still do this really fun work, even though we don't have some of our materials. Just remember that when we're coloring, we should color all the pieces that have the same value the same color. So I could color this square red, or this is yellow. And then maybe I've got this square red. A very small colored pencil now. I use red a lot, I guess. And then blue. Where's my blue? There's my blue. Color that in blue. And I know this is 1, 2, 3, 4 by 6. These colors choices remind me of the artist Piet Mondrian. Don't know who it is? You should check it out. He did very geometric work featuring the primary colors. And then I would label it. So this is 4 squared. This is 4 times, well, 6 times 4 technically. And then this is 4 times 6, and then 6 squared. And then we'd write out 4 squared plus 6 times 4 plus 4 times 6 plus 6 squared, and solve from there.